This was not my dream, by the way. I didn't play like Hot Rod Shop when I was a little girl with my Barbies, you know, taking them in. We started in writing and photography for automotive magazines, and then we started doing marketing, and then that led to building demo vehicles for people. And then my husband, Chris, always wanted to build a 67 C10, so we started doing that. And then people started saying, wow, that's awesome. Can you build one for me? And we're like, that's a business. It's amazing. So we got a shop, started taking in small jobs, and then the car that pretty much put us over the top was a 1969 Camaro that we called Draco. It was just gloss black, beautiful. It was for a pro NFL player, David Carr, at the time. And that one really got us a lot of attention, and then our phones started blowing up. The difference with us is we didn't take anything ordinary. We wouldn't just take in a car that needed suspension or that needed seats or just onesie twosie stuff. We really held out for the big builds and the really expensive stuff, and it was super hard in the beginning because you just want to take anything that comes through the door to pay the bills. And we just said we weren't going to do that. We wanted to be elite, and so that's kind of got us where we are today. Most people will bring their car in and think it can be painted in 2 days, and all this stuff is only going to take maybe 5 or 6 weeks, and it takes a year to 2 years. And custom bodywork and metalwork takes hours and hours and hours and tons of experience, and a lot of shops just don't do that. They do buy stuff and bolt it on and line it up so it fits a little bit better and then call it custom, and we don't do that. We spend so much time on these cars that we have a piece of our heart sold into it. Body shop. They do paint body. They do a lot of insurance work. They're really good at it. Buddy comes in and says, hey, I want to build a 69 Camaro. We can do that. How hard can it be? We bolt on sheet metal all day long. We paint cars. So they get themselves into this predicament where they say they can be a hot rod builder. And when they get down to it, they're like, yeah, this car's 45 years old. Holy crap. We don't know how to fix that. We don't know how to do that. You want us to shave the door handles? What is that about? And so they may be good in their field, but they're not good in restoration. So we do get a lot of clients that will ask us to go pick up a car from another shop that it's been for two and a half years. And it's just sitting. And of course they've given these people all this money in advance, and they have nothing to show for it.